Hi everybody, welcome to our new video. Today we're gonna learn how to optimize a table. For whatever reason, I don't know why you want to optimize the table, but we're going to show you how to do that. Okay, right? Yeah, we're gonna use phpMyAdmin, and that's what we're gonna use. We're using Linux, but it's the same as long as you using phpMyAdmin, no matter which Windows you're using, which operating system you're using, maybe using Mac, maybe Windows or Linux, Ubuntu, Linux, Kali and Mint, whatever you have, it's not that much of a stress. So because the interface is the same, so what changes gonna be just your operating system, so that shouldn't be a stress. So go to your localhost. It's gonna be localhost phpMyAdmin. Okay, once you type in that, you have to log into your thing. So now you can decide if you're gonna optimize the entire table, the entire database, or the entire table. So here we're gonna try to optimize the entire database, and also we're gonna do the entire table. So one table, so I have 70 tables here. You scroll down to the to the bottom, then you click here check all. We check all of them, then you select here and say optimize table, click there. After that, it's doing the job now. Let's give it some few minutes. It's gonna be there. So it depends on how big is the database. So if the database is small, 2-3 tables, then it's okay. There's not much data, then it's okay. It's gonna be very fast. So now here we sitting on 70 tables, which have a lot of data anyway. So that's why I see that it doesn't take seconds, you get me. So let's see, let's wait and see. Let's just be a little bit patient. It's gonna be fine soon. It's gonna be very fine once we optimize it. There's a lot of things we're going to explain to you after that, because we're expecting some things maybe you've never seen. After that, it's a very good thing to optimize your tables. You can as well go to Google and search benefits of optimizing a table, so you'll see why you should optimize your table. There are some plugins on WordPress, in case you have a WordPress site, which does that job for you. So maybe you might ask that, what if I'm using something like WordPress, what can I do? There are plugins which can help you on doing that. You get very good ones. Yeah, good enough, we're done. After doing that, you're gonna realize that it says it, what it does anyway, it creates the same table, it makes a copy of that same table, then it takes the data from that table, then puts it in the second table. But here you can see it says table does not support optimization. Okay, so what does that mean? You can see most of them here, they don't support optimization, but there is a table like here, which is okay. You can see it says that optimization status table is already up to date, right? Then we go down. There's another table I want to show you. It says also tables up to date. Why I'm showing you this table, you can see that this table, it doesn't have any other table like this one. This one is called subject timetable. There are two. Remember I told you optimization creates a duplicate table, then it takes all the information from the original table, then dumps it in here. So here you can see that there's only one table, so it doesn't have a copy. Why? It has done that already, then it optimized the table, then it deleted that old table. You understand? So but here it failed because it says that this table does not support optimization. What's the reason why this is happening like this? The major reason is optimization is not supported on InnoDB tables, you can see. So that's why you see that. So any table which is optimized, you're gonna find out that table is what is a MyISAM table. So I'm gonna copy this table here. So we're gonna check that it's gonna be my ISAM. You get me? So also we're gonna try to optimize one by one, and you're gonna see that all inner table TB, tables, they are not going to give us that chance to optimize them. So okay, I'm gonna copy that table, and there are a couple of them here which are my ISAM, so they are optimizable, but DB tables, they don't allow optimization. So let's go back to structure, and I'm gonna search for this table. Okay, you can see this table when I click on it and I go to operations, you can see this table is a what, is a MyISAM table. So that's why it allowed optimization. I'm gonna go back again to my database. Okay, I'm gonna go to this database and I try to optimize that table. I'm looking for that table. I'm gonna select it and I say optimize. It won't take time because it's just one table and it's gonna allow us to optimize. So I'm gonna say optimize table. You see 2 seconds done, say already whatever. So it means that is fine. So I'm gonna go select another table in the DB here. I'm gonna select this categories, whatever. Let me see. Yeah, this is the inner DB table. Okay, that table, I'm gonna copy that table, then I go back to the DB, I search for that table, then what we're gonna do, we're gonna optimize that table. So when we go to optimize, it won't allow us, it's gonna give us the same message it gave last time. So those inner DB tables gives all the time. So we go here down and we look for optimize table, optimize. Okay, you can see it's taking time also, but now it's done. It tells you that table does not support optimization doing recreate. So that's the thing. So you can see that InnoDB table does not allow optimization, but anyway, that's the reason, that's the thing why I'm saying that's the thing, the optimization process. So it doesn't take even time much if your tables don't have a lot of things, but anyway, if you want to optimize one table, it takes seconds, just a blink of an eye, the table's done, optimization. So guys, please don't forget to subscribe and I hope you enjoyed the video, and if there's something we didn't show, please, or any other way, because people know a lot of things in a different way, please try to notify us in our comment box below. Don't forget to subscribe, don't forget to like, don't forget to share on Facebook or Twitter or anywhere. Thanks, and see you in the next video.